कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरद्विजे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै सदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय सदभक्ताय नमो यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुकेतमपेतकृत्यं दैपायनो गिरः पातर्यासु पुत्रेति तन्मयतया सर्वो तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवान् राधे First of all, my millions of dandas pranam in the lotus feet of my Parma Rajatam Guru Dev, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pas Ismat Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj. And same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pas Ismat Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj.
首先我向我的灵性导师圣主伊切利拉和维斯坦欧姆比什努卡徐巴基比亚可以舍口双眼的莲花族注意自己千百万次礼拜此外呢我向我的像同样也向呢伊切利拉和维斯坦欧姆比什努卡的徐巴基比丹塔双眼莲花族的自己千百万次礼拜
That if anyone wants to be happy forever, no suffering at all, then they should have devotion of Supreme Lord Krishna. They should hear His glory, they should speak His glory, qualities, and cherish three pastimes of the Supreme Lord. And this is Bhakti Yoga. Yoga means now in the world what is going on, that is not yoga. This is like exercise for body. Yoga means there should be two things. And if they are added, then it is yoga. 1 + 1 = 2. 4 + 5 = 9. So what is yoga? Eternal transcendental yoga. Jeev is transcendental. Soul is transcendental. And Supreme Lord Krishna is transcendental. How we can be related with Him? How we can please Him by our services?
For this is Bhakti Yoga. 那么现在所进行的一切的话呢都与这些东西无关的因为瑜伽呢应该是两样东西的就是一加一等于二或者说四加五等于九类似这样的加法那么呢Krishna是超然的而我们个体灵也是超然的那么这种呢两个超然东西的连接呢这就称为呢就奉爱瑜伽
Really, in this world, they are very fortunate. Those who have faith in hearing Hari Katha. For Bhakti Yoga, they should serve high class of devotees. Those who have realized Supreme Lord. Those who are always chanting Krishna name with tear in his eyes. And they should be in Tirtha, Tirthas, in Vrindavan, Sri Navadvip Dham, or Neelachal Dham. There always so many sadhus are there, practicing bhakti yoga. By this, their soul will be must happy. Then nasta prayesu abhadresu. Read this shloka.
那么在这个世界上我们是很幸运的，得以聆听和享受呢Krishna他讲了关于Krishna的利益。那么在这个，我们应该去服务呢，对Krishna有品位的这些高阶的奉献者，并且呢去聆听和唱诵圣名，因为他们呢对灵，他们总是唱诵圣名啊，对Krishna有内在的觉悟。那么在Vrindavan和在Navadvip的话呢，有很多这类型的圣人。
So, Srila Gurudev has been explaining to us this subject matter of pure bhakti yoga, how our soul can unite with the Supreme Soul, Sri Krishna.
One mic broken. Should be fixed. So the process of yoga, Srila Gurudev explained that in this world, people that are practicing so-called yoga is mainly just physical exercises.
实际上现今世界他们所修习的瑜伽的话都是身体的活动，那么都是呢，随着铺垫而指出来的。It
is not actually yoga, because the very word yoga means to unite together.
因为这实际上不是真正的瑜伽，因为瑜伽yoga这个词的话是连接的意思。Like
Srila Gurudev said, 1 + 1 = 2.
就像随着铺垫刚才提到了，一加一才能等于二。
So what yoga actually refers to is the linking together, the uniting together of our soul, which Srila Gurudev is saying is transcendental, and linking together with the Supreme Soul, Sri Krishna, who is the Supreme Transcendental.
那么呢，实际上，Srila Gurudev提到了刚才讲的就是说呢，瑜伽真正的瑜伽的话呢，就是我们的灵魂，那么还有呢，超灵和两者呢都是超然的，那么他们的这个连接呢被称为呢，yoga。So
the process of bhakti yoga is the process by which our soul will be united eternally with the Supreme Soul in transcendental bhakti, which means pure love and devotion.
所以的话呢，瑜伽的意思的话呢，就是我们的个体灵魂与超灵永远的连接在一起。那么这被称为呢，bhakti yoga，纯粹的互爱。
Now, in our present condition, we have so many impediments, so many obstacles, which are preventing our soul from connecting with the Supreme Being. Just like, for example, if you have a magnet, and the magnet is automatically going to be attracted to a piece of metal, but if you put something to obstruct the magnetic force in between, like a brick, oh, then it will not become attracted. So in the same way, there are so many things that are called anarthas. These are unwanted things within our hearts preventing us from being able to be spontaneously attracted to the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. But Srimad Bhagavatam, which Srila Gurudev is explaining to us, has given a process of hearing constantly the glories of Sri Krishna from the lips of pure realized souls, and by this process, all these obstacles that are within our heart can become removed. So in the beginning of the Srimad Bhagavatam, this process is explained in the verses which Srila Gurudev is now quoting. Nashtatrayeshu avatreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama shloke bhaktir bhavati naishtiki. So here it is telling that nashtatrayeshu avatreshu, the process by which all of these unwanted things, material desires and so forth, can be removed is by doing Bhagavat Seva, service to Bhagavat. There are two types of Bhagavat. One Bhagavat is what we are hearing, this glorious scripture called Srimad Bhagavatam. The second type of Bhagavat is called the person Bhagavat or Bhakta Bhagavat. That is the pure devotee of Krishna who is completely surrendered to Krishna and has developed pure love and devotion to him. We are very fortunate to be in the presence of such a pure Bhagavat, Bhakta Bhagavat, our beloved Srila Gurudev. So Srimad Bhagavatam is telling, by hearing from the lips of the pure devotee, by serving the pure devotee, then the things that have accumulated within our heart over many, many lifetimes, they gradually become removed. And then the result comes, Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki. Now, what is called fixed bhakti, bhakti that cannot be wavering at any time, it becomes completely fixed in one's heart. So Srimad Bhagavatam explains, Shrinvatam Svapata Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana Vidyantak Stohi Padrani Vidunauti Suhritsatam. By hearing the Srimad Bhagavatam, then that Krishna Katha is Krishna himself. And he comes within our own heart, and he cleanses the heart of the devotee.
Hmm?
Then Padarajastamo Bhava Kamalobha Dayaschaye Chaita Ekayana Vibham Stitam Satve Prasidati. In this material world, all conditioned souls, they are covered. Their consciousness is covered over by different degrees of covering of the modes of material nature, passion and ignorance.
各种受条件限制的灵魂的话呢，都被不同程度的覆盖。那么这种覆盖包括哈愚昧形态以及呢畸形形态。
When one is covered by the modes of passion and ignorance, then so much material lust, anger, greed, illusion, envy, it stays within one's heart, and one cannot realize transcendental truth.
那么当一个人被愚昧和畸形所覆盖的时候，那么内心中的色欲、贪婪、愤怒、嫉妒等等的东西的话呢？
But by this process of hearing Krishna Katha, then the lower modes of passion and ignorance, the effect, no longer comes into one's consciousness, and one gradually rises to the mode of goodness, and in that mode of goodness, now he becomes situated in sattva gun, and he becomes very happy.
这种基本的这种形态的话呢，不会再进入我们自觉。那我们提升到善良形态，这时候我们就变得快乐。Just
like Srila Gurudev said in the very beginning of his lecture tonight, that the whole process to become happy is only by hearing Krishna Katha.
那么刚才一开篇的时候呢，Gurudev已经提到了，那么要想快乐，永远的快乐，永不受苦，那么必须呢去聆听Hari Katha。
So when this hearing of Harikatha progresses more and more, then Vidyate Hridaya Granthis Chidyante Sarva Shamshaya Chiyante Chasya Karmani Drishta Evadma Nishvare. Then there is a knot within one's heart which is binding one to this material world, binding us to identify ourselves with these material bodies.
那么在我们心中，我们是有一个缠结，有一个硬结的，捆绑我们，与这个世界捆绑我们，让我们留在这儿。
And that knot keeps us in this material world, lifetime after lifetime, thinking I am this body, and everything connected with this body belongs to me.
那么这个结，让我们累生累世，都留在这个世界上，让我们想着我就是这个身体。
This false illusion of material identity within this world, it is the diseased condition of our soul.
所以这个就是说，以为我们是这个世界，属于这个世界，那么这是一种疾病的状态。So
now when this powerful transcendental knowledge enters within the heart, then the knot of material existence becomes pierced and we become freed from these material conceptions.
所以的话，当这种知识，这种有威力的知识进入我们心中之后，那么这个缠结被打开了，那么我们就
Chidlante, Sarva Samsaya, all doubts, they become cleared within the heart and one comes into transcendental existence.
那么呢，心中疑惑尽除，然后我们进入了这种超然的这个存在。
And the chain of material existence of repeated birth and death, which is caused by our karma lifetime after lifetime, now it becomes terminated.
那么这个生死之恋，让我们累世